I imagine when you were in Helmand Province in your last, in 2010 and 11, you said, right, one of the hottest fighting areas of the war, you must have dealt with the local populations. So can you describe how your interactions were and whether by that time there was already a loss of trust between the occupying forces, Americans and other coalition forces, and the local populations?
Yeah, you know, it really is, I think, locally determined. Those small unit leaders on the ground operating really can affect the trust level in their area. I can give you a quick example of a Marine battalion in Helmand. There was the Taliban had planted a rumor that a Quran, the Americans had burned a Quran, and of course that is pretty egregious in the Muslim community. So a riot broke out. They surrounded the village population, got together and started. The American Marines kind of formed a circle, and they started getting pelted with rocks, mm-hmm. and getting hit. I saw pictures of this. I was there soon afterwards, but the Marines held their fire. They would actually, under the rules of engagement at the time, would have been authorized to use force to protect themselves, but they held their fire despite taking serious injuries. They found out that it was a rumor, that the local population realized, oh, this was a rumor, and it diffused the situation. But that restraint that the Marines showed paid off. In the following weeks, that unit had the highest, what we call a find and cleared rate for IEDs based on tips. So the local population was actually cooperating with that unit, telling them, hey, there's an IED down the road at this location. You might want to dig it up before it kills you. So they built trust in that case by their actions, by, in this case, exercising the restraint that really impressed, I think, the locals as well. We were throwing rocks at them, and they didn't fight back. So that takes a lot of discipline, but you're exactly right. Another unit could have done something, you know, on the other extreme and lost the trust of the population, and it would have, you know, the cooperation would have gone the other direction, and it might be helping the Taliban, you know, emplace the IEDs or tell them where the Americans are and where they're going to be.
Yeah, I was never in Afghanistan, but I covered the war in Iraq and was embedded with military units, and there were certainly soldiers and officers who saw things the way you describe, but there were also those that saw Iraqis as the other. And it occurred to me as you were telling me that story that whoever commanded that platoon of Marines said these are human beings, and they saw things at that level, from a humanitarian level. And tried to figure it out as opposed to just seeing them as the enemy. That's not really a question.
Yeah. Well, no, and I will say this is one thing we found in Afghanistan. Even General McChrystal pointed this out, that the longer units stayed in an area and interacted with the population, you know, the more they were observed to the more limited collateral damage and civilian casualties incidents that occurred. There was a correlation between the time spent interacting with the population, getting to know them, and I think you're exactly right. They develop empathy, and it really humanizes the situation. It's not the enemy.